Looking to take your financial knowledge to the next level? You're in the right place. Welcome to Ask Ralph, offering accounting, technical, and financial advice. Whether you're looking to save taxes or improve your business, he's got you covered. Here's your host of Ask Ralph, Ralph Eastup Jr.
Hello and welcome back to the Ask Ralph Show. My name is Ralph Eastup. I'm the host of the Ask Ralph Show. If this is your first time joining us, I'll say welcome. You will find this show to be a very exciting time and when we talk about all kinds of matters of finance and tax and things like that. If you've joined us before, I say welcome back. Today, I thought I might take a few minutes and talk about the holidays and more specifically, how to recover financially from the holidays. And we're in the midst of it right now. You know, if you look around, there's all kinds of shopping going on and, you know, preparing for the Christmas and for the holiday season. But, you know, this is where people can get themselves into a lot of trouble. So let's talk about some ideas about how to recover financially after overspending during the holidays. And I'm saying this now because maybe there's still time to head that off at the pass. Number one thing, in my view, is to develop a plan. And, you know, it's not too late to do that, actually. And what I mean by a plan there is before you do anything, you know, the key to this survival or this recovering is to really start off with a plan. Right now, I think the plan would be, you know, what am I going to spend during the holidays? And that would be something as simple as, you know, setting a budget for each of the people you intend to spend on, you know, and then you need to stick to that budget. You know, it's real easy when you're out shopping to get carried away or you see something, I got to have that. That's a sale I've got to do. But if you plan ahead, you know, and make a list, and you know, I've done this with my kids for a long time, you know, make a list of the people that you are going to see or that you normally buy gifts for during the holidays, and then set a budget for each person and then stick to that budget. You know, that's pretty simple. Now, after the holidays, if you've already gone overboard, then we talk about a different kind of plan. And that's a plan of how to pay back all the debt as quickly as possible without dipping into your emergency savings and all that sort of thing. And one of the things that a lot of people mention is a website called mint.com, and it's a budgeting site. So you might take a look at that and use that to help you, or readyforzero.com, which is a website where they help you develop strategies for getting out of debt. So now, once you're past the holiday season, you know, putting your credit cards away is a good idea. And you can do that before the holidays as well. You know, if you're going to develop that budget of what you're going to spend during the holidays, you know, maybe the best option is sort of the old school envelope option. You put the money that you're going to spend on Christmas gifts right in that envelope, and you only spend, you know, what's in that envelope. That way you don't have that concern about going to the store with that credit card and running up that credit card balance. Because if they're not in your wallet, you can't use them. And it cuts away those impulsive buys. So if you've got the plan, you've got the budget, then you don't have that credit card with you. You don't have to worry about overindulging. Once you get past that, you know, pay extra whenever you can. Big picture here is never, never, ever ignore your debt. The bills don't go away, and it has the potential to ruin your credit over a very short period of time. So once you've gotten yourself in that position where you are, you know, potentially paying some credit card balances back, the key is to pay extra whenever you can to get those balances down as quickly as you can. You know, if you pay just the minimum balance, then you're going to end up carrying that debt for a long time and it's just going to escalate on you. Another thing you could do is stay out of the stores, both online and in person. A lot of times if you go into the stores, you know, you might see something you just have to have. You're not just going to go and look, you're going to go and find something. You know, you feel like you've made that trip, you need to buy something. So if you stay out of the stores and stay off of the online shops and just focus in on what you need, you know, whatever's on that list or whatever's on that budget, that's a really smart thing to do. Now, one of the obvious things to do is return anything you didn't use or unwanted gifts. You know, if somebody really gives you something and you don't intend to use it, to me, it makes absolutely no sense to just set it on a shelf somewhere. You know, you have a couple options. I'm going to ask them for a receipt and take it back, or make a charitable contribution with that gift. You know, if you're not going to use it, it absolutely makes no sense to put it in the closet and never look at it again. You know, one of the things you may have to consider as well, you know, if you've gotten yourself into a position where you've spent too much during the holidays, is make some personal sacrifices. And when you're trying to get back on your feet financially, it's important you realize that you're going to have to make some personal sacrifices. Now, that could be something as simple as, you know, maybe brown bagging your lunch. You know, if you're somebody who eats out for lunch every day, you know, one of the easy ways to save money is to brown bag it or pack yourself a lunch every day. You know, you might cancel some subscriptions that you have, you know, whether you're, you know, it's a Netflix subscription. I'm not picking on Netflix or any of the others. You might say, look, you know, I just can't afford to do that, or skip out on some events that you normally do. But you're doing this because you don't want to have that financial burden hanging over your head, you know, continuously. Now, another option you could take a look at, and you have to be careful with this one as well, but consider a balance transfer or consolidating your debt. You know, if you've got a bunch of credit cards and you're only making the minimum payments on them, you know, one of the things you might want to consider is transferring that to a credit card with a lower interest rate. But you have to make sure that they're not going to charge you a transfer fee. And you have to ask that question, because in some cases, they consider that type of consolidation or bank transfer actually a cash withdrawal, and they will charge you an extra fee or a percentage of that to do that transfer. So you got to ask that question ahead of time. If you find yourself in a position where you've got multiple credit cards or multiple debts that you have to pay, the big point is to focus on paying the debt with the highest interest rate first. So if we've already gotten past the plan and the plan didn't go well, and you took the credit cards with you when you were shopping, and you went out to the online stores, you went out to the shopping malls, you went to the online stores, and you really overindulged, what you need to do now is really focus on paying the debt with the highest interest rate first. So you got to take a look at your bills and say, okay, well, this one's got a 18% interest rate. This one has a 29% interest rate. Well, obviously, it'd be better to pay the 29% interest rate first. Now, make sure you're making at least the minimum payment on the lower credit card debts, because you don't want to get yourself in a position where you're going to ruin your credit. And the other thing you need to be careful of is making sure you don't get over your credit limit, or if you make a late payment, because they will really zonk you with fees for that. I've seen, you know, with some of my clients with their work, you know, if you make a late payment, they're charging you a $25 fee. Or let's say that you go over your balance. You know, that's great. They're going to cover the purchase, but they might charge you a $39 fee. I think I saw one not too long ago that was a $39 fee for going over your balance. And it was just a continuous thing every day until your balance dropped below. So you got to pay attention to these things. And like I said, at the beginning of this, the key in my view is develop a plan and stick to that plan. Now, a lot of us aren't, you know, regimented enough to do that, but that really is the key. So rather than saying, you know, how can we recover? That is the key to that, is getting started ahead of time. So I hope this was helpful. If you're interested in any of our other podcasts, you can go right to our website, which is askralph.com, or you can go to where you get your podcast and just look for the Ask Ralph podcast. And I'd love to hear from you. In fact, if you call my office today at 302-659-6560, I'll give you a $50 gift certificate towards the preparation of your taxes for this year. Again, that's 302-659-6560. Let's hear from you and let's get some money.
You've been listening to Ask Ralph, brought to you by Sazio Accounting Plus. Please subscribe to and rate our podcast on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your podcasts, and leave us a rating and review. Our podcast is produced by Carolyn Peters. Thank you for listening, and be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at Ask Ralph Media. You can also hear me each week on 1450 WILM and on 1410 WDOV in Delaware, and on the iHeartRadio app. Submit your questions or ideas for future shows by sending an email to AskRalph@AskRalph.com.
The information contained in this episode of Ask Ralph is based on data available as of the date of its release. Sazio Accounting Plus and Ask Ralph Media Inc. is under no obligation to update this content if changes occur. Applying this information to your specific situation requires careful consideration of all facts and circumstances, and any information provided is not to be considered as financial, tax, or legal advice. Please consult your tax advisor or attorney before acting on any material covered.